YouTube, what's going on, man? You locked in with Relly Fam, and I'm your one and only Relly. Man, look, today. Now, what we got for you today, we got some curry goat. That's right, I said it, curry goat. Now, some people been requesting me to make this curry goat. A lot of people want me to make oxtails, which I'm gonna make oxtails. I got a video coming up for y'all with oxtails, so stay tuned. Make sure y'all stay locked in with that too, so. Today I'ma marinate, you know, all the flavors that's gonna be tied into the curry goat, and we're gonna let it marinate overnight, and we're gonna actually be cooking it tomorrow. Thank y'all for the support. Thank you for everybody who subscribed, for everybody who liked the video, for everybody that's been rocking with Relly Fam, showing me all the love. I appreciate the support, because like I said, we got a lot more coming. But with that being said, I ain't gonna do too much talking, because you know I don't like to do all that long-winded stuff. So let's get right into the video. So here's the ingredients to this curry goat. All right, we got our curry goat, carrots that's already chopped, white vinegar, apple cider vinegar, green onions, we got thyme, scotch bonnet hot pepper sauce, one actual scotch bonnet pepper, black pepper, curry powder, oxtail seasoning, pimento berries, tomatoes, ginger, garlic, onions, peppers, chicken broth, canola oil, and potatoes. Now, like I was trying to say, this recipe is a big one. It's about 20 ingredients that's involved in it. But like I said, you're gonna see how simple it is. You know, we get this process started. You see how simple it is. It seemed like a lot, but it's really not that much. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna rinse our goat with water and vinegar. The reason you rinse it with the water and the vinegar, number one, you wanna always clean your meat. That's the first thing you're gonna do. Any type of meat you cooking, I don't care what it is, you gonna clean it. You gonna rinse it up under some water, some fresh water, and get all the stuff off of it. The vinegar, you wash it with the vinegar to try to get the any gamey taste that it might have, that goat might have. You want to get the gamey taste off of it. So you clean it with the vinegar and water, take care of that. But I ain't gonna do too much talking. Let's get right into it. Okay, Relly Fam, so now we got our goat rinsed off with the vinegar, with the water. We got them all seasoned up real good. We got them all, you know, peppers all mixed in and everything, all the ingredients mixed in all nice. We're gonna let them sit overnight. So tomorrow, we gonna cook them. That's all we got left to do. Hopefully y'all take your notes the way you're supposed to be taking notes, you know. Well, yeah, I guess I just see y'all back tomorrow. All right. So now we bite from yesterday. You remember yesterday we marinated the goat? So this is what we got. Yes, sir. So yeah, that's what we got for the marination process. I'm a little bit disappointed because my Dutch pot that came in right here, it's a little bit smaller than what I'd like it to be, but we still gonna make it work. So basically what we gonna do, we just gonna cook half the day and then half tomorrow. You see the pot was already smoking, that means it's ready. I already got 3 tablespoons of canola oil in there. So basically what we gonna do first, we gonna brown the goat, meaning we just gonna sear the outsides, which just locks the flavor in, you know, that way, lock the juices in, should I say. So, you know, the only way the juice gonna come out is if you bite it, you know, so that'll make your meat more juicy when you sear it first. So that take about a good 10 minutes. So let's get to cooking. Now it's time to flip them over. It's been like 3 minutes. See that? That's what you want. That's what you want. That's gonna lock them juices right in there. Yes, sir. Yeah, Lord. All right, now we're gonna take them out. What a good friend of mine told me, he told me that it's better if you put some seasoning, some curry seasoning in and cook it first. So we're gonna put a little bit of seasoning in there, right? And since we only doing half, we're gonna take a half of a scotch bonnet pepper and just drop it in there. All right. Okay, fam. So now that we got all that done, we got it seared up. We gonna let it sit for like 10 more minutes. And then once it sit for 10 more minutes, you will see that goat meat, it gives off its own juices. So once I open the pot and show y'all, you'll see the juice that's coming out the goat meat already, right? Yeah, so we gonna do that and then we'll come back. And see y'all then. So, we haven't touched it since we put it in. Let's see what the juices did, right? Wow, look at that. That's without any broth. That's without anything. Haven't put nothing in here yet. So now what we do, all right, so it's been like 30, 40 more minutes. So let's see where we at with it. See, she's getting kind of thick. Let me taste it real quick. Let me see how tender she is. I just tasted a piece. It's definitely good. Delicious. Not quite tender enough yet. But I say we got about another 25 minutes at the most, and it'll be ready to go. So now what we'll do, we'll add in some more broth and bring it back to another boil and just let it go for another 20 minutes. And then we'll throw those potatoes and those carrots in there. So actually, we're actually gonna throw the carrots and the potatoes in there in like 10 more minutes, because this will be done in like 25 minutes. So you wanna get the potatoes and the carrots like at least 15 minutes to cook, because you want to be done, but you don't want to be too soft. That's why we just wait on those. All right, I think we at the finish line. Let's see. Ooh, nah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's what you want. That is what you want. OM God. Okay, fam. Now this is the moment we all been waiting for. So I know I'm starving. I ain't eating in a while. Y'all probably hungry after watching this video, but let's go ahead and do this taste test real quick. Matter of fact, let me say my blessings, because without him, he wouldn't be here with this delicious. All right, let's see where we at.
Can you get a close up on this?
See that gravy is real thick. Yeah, let's just see. Hey, you. I promise you, I'm not exaggerating. It tastes phenomenal, immaculate, stupid good. Like, anyway, really, fam. Yeah, my son in the background, he doing whatever he do. He whatever. I hope y'all liked this video. If you did like the video, comment down below. Let me know if it's something that you want me to make that I haven't made yet. I'll probably get around to it eventually, but if you didn't like it, tell me what you didn't like about it. If you tried it at home, and if you did try it, then let me know in the comments what you thought about it, if you tried it, if it come out good for you or not, but this came out great for me. So I'm starving, I'm about to dig into this plate. Oh yeah, up under here I got rice. So without further ado, I'm gone. That's how we gonna end the video. Hope you like it. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. We out.